In this lesson, we will discuss the determinant of a square matrix. The determinant of a matrix is denoted by the absolute value sign surrounding the matrix name, and is a value that helps us determine whether or not a solution to a set of linear equations exists. If the determinant is not equal to zero, then there is a unique solution to the set of linear equations. If the determinant is equal to zero, then there is no unique solution to the set of linear equations. There may be no solution or an infinite number of solutions. If the determinant is very small, we say that the matrix is ill-conditioned. For ill-conditioned matrices, the solutions to the unknowns are highly sensitive to the values in the A matrix, and this can be problematic as computers cannot store numbers with infinite precision, and small round-off errors can lead to large errors in the solution. Finally, the inverse of a matrix exists if the matrix determinant is non-zero. The determinant can be calculated through a straightforward process. First, we will calculate the determinant of a 2x2 matrix. Here we have two equations, 1x1 plus 3x2 equals 5, and 2x1 plus 6x2 equals 9. The corresponding coefficient matrix is 1, 3, 2, 6. The determinant of a 2x2 matrix is calculated by subtracting the product of the diagonals. 1 times 6 minus 3 times 2 equals 0. A zero determinant means there is no unique solution to this set of equations. In general, for a 2x2 matrix, the determinant is equal to A11 times A22 minus A12 times A21. Calculating the determinant for a 3x3 matrix takes a bit longer. Here we have a general 3x3 matrix in which the 9 elements are described by their row and column indices. We multiply each of the elements in the top row, A11, A12, and A13, with the 2x2 determinant of the elements that are not in the same row or column, and we call this 2x2 determinant a minor. Element A11 is multiplied by the determinant of A22, A23, A32, A33, which are the four elements not in the same row or column as element A11. We subtract from that element A12 multiplied by the determinant of A21, A23, A31, A33, then add element A13 multiplied by the determinant of A21, A22, A31, A32. Notice that the sign in front of the lead elements, A11, A12, and A13, alternates. You can determine the sign by adding the row and column number. Let's label the row number as I and the column number as J. If I plus J is equal to an even number, a positive sign should be placed in front of the lead element. If I plus J is equal to an odd number, a negative sign should be placed in front of the lead element. The number of operations necessary to calculate a determinant grows as n factorial, so calculating the determinant for very large matrices can take a very long time. The determinant of a matrix is related to whether or not the system of equations is linearly independent. A system of equations is not linearly independent if it is possible to generate at least one of the rows of the coefficient matrix by either multiplying another row with a constant factor or using a linear combination of multiple rows. The same applies for columns of the coefficient matrix. For example, here is a coefficient matrix for a system that is not linearly independent. 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5. Notice that you can generate the second row by multiplying the first row by a factor of 2. Here's another coefficient matrix for a system that is not linearly independent. 1, 4, 5, 4, 1, 5, 2, 4, 6. While the rows appear to demonstrate linear independence, you can generate the third column by adding the first and second columns. The determinant of both matrices is 0, and the matrices do not have an inverse. Here are examples of two matrices from linearly independent systems of equations. The first matrix is 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 4, 2, 1, 1, and the second matrix is negative 1, negative 2, 0, 9, 9, 9, 8, 7, 6. There is no way to generate a row or column from the other rows and columns. The determinant is not zero for these two matrices, and the matrices do have an inverse. MATLAB has a built-in function named DEET that calculates the determinant of a square matrix. At the command line, we create a 2x2 array named A with the statement A equals 1, 3, 2, 6. Notice that we can generate the second row by multiplying the first row by a factor of 2, so we should expect a zero determinant. We can calculate the determinant of A by typing DET open parentheses A close parentheses. And indeed we find that the determinant is 0. Now we will store a 3x3 matrix in A. A equals 1, 2, 3, 5, 2, 1, 1, negative 1, 0. All the rows and columns are linearly independent, so we should expect a non-zero determinant. We type DET A and find that the determinant is negative 18. So if we calculate the inverse of A using the statement INVA, we find that an inverse does indeed exist. Let's see what happens if we try to take the inverse of a matrix that has a zero determinant. Here we have a 3x3 matrix, 1, 1, 1, 5, 5, 5, 0, 1, 2. The second row can be generated by multiplying the first row by a factor of 5, so the system of equations is not linearly independent. When we calculate the determinant using the DET function, we obtain 0 as expected. When we try to take the inverse using the INV function, we obtain a message warning us that all the elements in the inverse matrix have a value of INF, which is short for infinity. This occurs when a number is too large to store in memory and is an indication that the system of equations is not linearly independent.